And biro intact and all, you have 30 seconds to introduce your question.
Minister, for the 5 years of the last Dail, I asked a litany of questions about what I consider to be very serious concerns about the corporate governance of Dunleary Harbour. Payments of expenses to directors that were turned out to be irregular, that was where the money was supposed to be got back, they didn't come back. Extra payments to the CEO. The saga of questions goes on. I'm not sure if you're aware, I'll elaborate in a second. The latest accounts of Dunleary Harbour companies show a €6.5 million loss, increased from a €1 million loss last year. Are you going to take into account these serious questions and financial questions and corporate questions in terms of what the future for Dunleary Harbour Company is?
Thank you. The Minister has 2 minutes to reply.
I'd like to thank Deputy Boyd Barrett for raising this issue. I'm not sure how helpful I can be to him, but I'll be as helpful as I possibly can. I understand and I hear what you're saying there about you've previously raised these issues with my predecessors in relation to payments to the CEO of the port company and in relation to payments made to a director of the company. Every commercial state body must disclose the CEO's annual salary in the published annual report and accounts of the body, and Dunleary Harbour Company complies with this requirement. In relation to the amount of the CEO's salary queried by the deputy, I am advised that, for better or for worse, it was in line with government policy at that time. On the payment of other expenses to the CEO in 2011, one of my predecessors made his view known that the payment should not have been made. And I understand that the company has acknowledged this and confirmed that it will not happen again. The payment of expenses to directors is a matter of Dunleary Harbour Company in accordance with Code of Practice for the Governance of State Bodies. As was advised apparently in previous replies, the matter of payments to the director is the subject of legal action, and it would be wrong for me to comment any further on that. As the Deputy is aware, the Harbours Act 2015 provides the legislative basis for one of the key recommendations in national ports policy. Namely, the governments of 5 ports of regional significance should vest in more appropriate local authority-led governance structures. Dunleary Harbour Company, as a port of regional significance, is designated under the policy for transfer to Dunleary Rathdown County Council. The process of transferring governance and the future operational structures of the port are primarily matters for agreement between the local authority and the port.
You need to look into the issue of whether there's court proceedings, because my understanding is there's none. You're being told a porky, okay? Ask them very simply, is there a court date? Is there an actual court hearing due? And you're going to find out there isn't, okay? So they're not telling the truth, is my understanding. It needs to be checked. Earlier this year, the statutory auditors for Dunleary Harbour Company, Deloitte, resigned. This year, Pamela Carney, the auditor on the board, resigned. I've just told you the losses for the company, this just came out in May, have increased from 1 million to 6.5 million. Next week, on the 27th of July, the trustees of the pension board of the pension scheme have been asked into the pensions board to address serious concerns that have been raised by the worker pension trustees in terms of essentially the behaviour of the company in terms of the pension scheme. Right? The questions go on of serious problems and irregularities in terms of the financial and corporate governance of this harbour company. Minister, I put it to you, this company has to be dissolved. This quango, what you yourself once called a quango, has to be dissolved. Its operating loss this year was €500,000. The combined salaries, fees and Minister, so on of the CEO, directors and all the rest of it adds up to that loss.
Minister,
so
reply.
Can
Minister.
I put it to you, this quango has to be dissolved.
Minister.
Deputy Boy Barrett, I hear what you're saying. I'm not in a position to either contradict or confirm what you're saying about the legal action. My information is that there is a legal action going on. Yours obviously is that it's not. And I will resolve that in the next 2 or 3 days by obviously checking up on what you're saying. I don't in any way suggest that either party who's saying this to me is acting in bad faith, but there's obviously a misunderstanding or certainly a conflict of evidence about this. On the other matter, I'll say this. As you know, the transfer is due to happen, and the manner of the transfer will be finally decided if it's not resolved between the local authorities and the company, and it'll be finally decided in the last analysis by the minister. If there is a dispute as to the model chosen, it'll be a ministerial function to make that decision.
Thank you, Minister.
Let me just say this, I will bear in mind what you've said, certainly, if I am called on to make that decision at any stage.
Deputy.
As I said, the operating loss, not mind a huge increase in losses, but the operating loss is equivalent to the excessive salaries, fees, expenses and so on that are being paid to an executive that has essentially run this company into the ground. That in itself, on a financial basis, is the reason for its dissolution and the need for it to be put under council control, where we can have some real oversight and accountability in terms of what goes on. So I would urge the Minister to do that. And I know he offered before when I asked him that we might have some arrangement to meet some of the other stakeholders, because I think what the Minister is hearing is coming from the harbour company itself or from the senior council officials. I would like, hopefully in the next few weeks, if it was at all possible, to bring some of the other harbour stakeholders to meet with the Minister to discuss, if you like, the other side of the story of what the hell is going on in Dunleary Harbour Company, because it's not a good story, Minister.
Okay, thank you, Deputy Minister. You have 1 minute to respond.
I share your views about if an operating loss of that size is in existence and the chief executives and directors getting huge sums of money, I think that's wrong. I don't feel comfortable with that, and I never would. And I just say this, I think at the last occasion I said, I'd meet anybody you want to bring in. Of course, I wouldn't refuse to do that. I would like to do it. But I'll do it within the confines and within the restrictions that you're aware of the fact that my powers in this particular matter are limited. In other words, do not expect too much of the meeting, but I'll certainly listen to what you have to say, and where I can make decisions, I'll bear it in mind.
Thank you, Minister. We now move to question number 41 in the name of Deputy Eugene Murphy.